I'm from Vancouver Fairview.
Honourable Speaker, last week the Environment Minister once again explained away her failure to provide soil and manure test information to the Steel Springs Water Board. She claimed the information was privacy protected. But the Ministry itself required the tests in 2014 because the tests indicate the amount of nitrogen that can be safely absorbed by crops before water is contaminated. Provincial law requires proactive release of the requested public health information without delay. My question is to the Environment Minister. If she won't release the soil and manure tests that her own ministry demanded, will she immediately have the ministry conduct their own tests and release those to the Water Board without delay?
Minister of the Environment.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. And we have already canvassed the fact that the information in question is not owned by the ministry. It's not the ministry's information. And so there are legal requirements with respect to keeping that information confidential. However, I do note that the Privacy Commissioner has been asked to look into this. And of course, we would follow any recommendations that flow from that. There is indeed another community meeting tonight. Staff have been working diligently to put together their best plans with respect to both monitoring as well as testing, and they will be discussing how they move forward with next steps at that meeting tonight. I would certainly encourage community members to be there. There will be every ministry and agency that are involved in the issue present.
Vancouver Fairview on a supplemental.
Well, thank you, Honourable Speaker. There is indeed a community meeting tonight with ministry staff in attendance. It's the third such community meeting over a period of 3 years, and residents say the meetings are exactly the same. Promises to study the issue, no plan of action, and not the information that was requested. The issue's urgent, Honourable Speaker. The 2016 crop season is upon us. Chief Christian of the Splatson First Nation and area residents depend on the Halkar Aquifer. Nitrate levels are 30% above Canada drinking water quality guidelines. They continue to rise, and residents want a moratorium on further manure spraying until water quality can be assured. Will the Minister of Environment simply end her delays and excuses and commit today that she will stop manure spraying above the Halkar Aquifer until safe, clean drinking water can be assured?
Minister of the Environment.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. In fact, there has not been any application since August. Nothing has been spread since August. So the member's incorrect with respect to the idea that there is continued application of effluent. I have spoken to the chief, and we are working together to develop the best way for us to engage with their First Nation. But to the member's suggestion that somehow ministry staff, dedicated ministry staff from my ministry, agriculture, people from Interior Health, that they're not taking this seriously, I would just point him to the executive director of the Okanagan Basin Water Board, who in response to questions about the work that is being undertaken, had this to say. Anna Warwick-Sears said, quote, "I was struck by the strength of the response from the Ministry of Environment. I feel like the ministry took the issue seriously and has a plan going forward."